It is that time of day again. Pretty much an everyday occurrence in our household now. Amazon delivery. So, let's see. I wonder what it is. What could it be? Well, let's go take a look and see.
All right, let's see what it is here. I think I know. Yes, I do. It's another book. Would you imagine that? I'm not even sure I remember when I ordered this one. I think I heard a podcast episode. So, all right. Well, hey, let's just go put it on the stack with all the other books right over here.
Now, you may be asking yourself, Bob, why do you have stacks and stacks of books sitting on your living room table? And that, my friend, is actually a great question. The answer, however, is even better. All of these books that you see in front of you today, including the one that I ordered that I forgot I ordered on Amazon, are all of the books that I've ordered on Amazon this year that, wait for it, I still haven't even read yet. Now, I gotta say, seeing them all organized here like this really leads me to believe that maybe I have a little bit of a problem when it comes to this area of my life. And listen, I've got a sneaky suspicion that if you're watching this channel, you probably can relate on some level. You've probably got a stack of books, although not quite as bad as this, somewhere in your house that you haven't read yet. But here's the thing, personal development's an amazing thing, right? As an entrepreneur and as a leader, we always have to be growing ourselves and getting better. And look, I'm kind of obsessed in this area if this isn't an indication. But as a leader, our desire to always want to grow and get better actually creates a big problem for us sometimes in our business. And here's what it is. We have a tendency to overtrain our teams. We teach them too much information. We read the good book, and then the first thing we want to go is teach everything we've learned to the people that are in our downline. And I'm telling you, this is creating a big issue in your business right now, whether you realize it or not. So stick around today. I'm going to help you answer the question, are you overtraining your team by teaching them too much? And I want to help make sure that you're not making this big mistake in your business. So stay tuned. Okay, I had to get those out of the way because if I'm honest, I really was starting to not feel so good about myself. But anyway, we've all been guilty on some level, right? Well, Bob Hylick here, your virtual upline. Today, I want to help you answer that really important question. Are you overtraining your team? Are you teaching them too much information and confusing them and actually holding them back in their business? So I want to start off this video by talking about what I believe to be the two biggest enemies of success in the network marketing profession. And those two things are, number one, fear, and number two is overwhelm. Now, when it comes to overwhelm, because this is really what we're talking about in this video today, I want you to understand that the vast majority of the people on your team that are not seeing results, it's not because they have an information problem. It's because they have an execution problem. They don't have the results that they want because they're not taking enough action. And you want to know why they're not taking enough action? Because they're totally confused and overwhelmed with all of the information that's being thrown at them every single day. Now, you may be asking yourself, Bob, are you saying that personal development isn't important? I'm not saying that at all. Personal development is critical. But here's the thing about personal development. Personal development, personal growth doesn't come from just learning and consuming information. It comes from the combination of learning and doing. You only grow when you are applying what you're learning. And I'm going to tell you the problem for the vast majority of people in this profession is they consume way too much training and content, and they actually produce and take action in such a small amount. And one of your responsibilities as a leader in this profession is to make sure that you're not contributing to this problem. And here's what that means. Every single book that you read, every podcast you listen to, every single YouTube video you watch should not be something that you are in turn teaching to your entire team. Because if that's happening right now, I promise you, you are a big part of the problem when it comes to them feeling overwhelmed. Look, I should know this because I made this mistake for a very long time in my business. I was the kind of leader where I would read a really good book and it would impact me in such a way. And here's where I think we run into trouble. It's like, you know, we consume something that has such an impact in our life that we naturally want to turn around and pour it into our teams. And that's what I would do. I would read a good book and I would take that book and all my notes and I would turn it into like an hour-long webinar that I would teach and train my team, or a two-hour seminar. And I'd be doing this all the time. It's every other week, it would seem like I'd have something different and something new that, listen, each thing on its own, you could argue, was very valuable. But when you understand what I'm teaching you today, what I didn't realize I was doing is I was contributing to the confusion and overwhelm of the people that were on my team. And because they were feeling overwhelmed, they were lacking the confidence to take action. And that's the reason why they weren't seeing results. See, what I didn't realize, and what I want you to understand, here's what's lacking for the majority of the people on your team right now that they absolutely need if they want to be successful: clarity. And I want you to understand, you must provide this for your team. Look, information and value is like water. Too much of it is just as bad as too little. See, what you need to learn how to do is you need to learn how to give your team clarity on what to do by keeping your training simple. See, one of the most important things that I learned about leadership is this: leadership is repetition. And when you think of keeping it simple and repetition, here's what that means: is leadership is basically you identifying the basic principles that somebody needs to master in order to be successful. And you basically say those over and over and over and over and over again in every single way you can, every single format possible, until your team finally gets it beat into their head. And you want to know where you're probably getting close? When you're so sick of hearing yourself say it, it's then and just then that they're probably finally just starting to get it. See, here's where a lot of us go wrong. We overtrain. We want to teach people everything we learn, but here's the reality. Most people are not ready for it. The new person's psychology is very fragile. They get overwhelmed so easily. Now, I want you to understand, what I'm teaching you here in this video doesn't apply to everybody in your business. See, on your team, you have what I call the 5%ers. And I bet if you think of this, there's probably no more than about 5% of the people on your team, just a handful of people, that are the real leaders, that don't need their hands held, that are responsible for the majority of your results. These people, the more advanced ones, I'm not talking about. I'm talking about the 95%, the vast majority that are afraid, they are overwhelmed, they are confused, and they don't have the results they want. Those are the people that you have to be very careful about what you're teaching them. So if they don't have the clarity, because every week or every month you're teaching them something new, they're gonna lose sight of what the most important things are. And that leads me to the second ingredient that you really need to focus on. Once you give people clarity, it allows them to focus. Focus is critical for building a successful business. And when we talk about focus, it's just making sure that your team is clear at all times on what are the basic things they need to know, right? Prospecting, recruiting, presenting, following up. Look, there's only a handful of things that somebody needs to learn and master. Maybe a little bit of goal setting, but very basic. There's only a handful of things that people need to master to go out and at least create a result. Look, if you don't have a single person on your team, here's what you don't need from me as a leader. You don't need me giving you some sort of advanced social media or attraction marketing training. You don't need me giving you a two-hour manifestation boot camp. You don't need me giving you an advanced training on the science behind our products and a detailed compensation plan overview. You don't need that stuff. You want to know what you need? You need to learn how to stop spamming people and send a message that will start a conversation so you can actually get your first recruit. See, this is what focus is, and it's your job as a leader to make sure you're keeping your team focused. And that leads me to the third critical ingredient that you need for success. You need clarity, you need focus. And when you have those two things, it allows you to do the third, which is consistency. Look, here's the fastest way to freedom in the network marketing profession: to get a large group of people to do a few simple things consistently over time. Now, here's the trick. Here's the catch. That large group of people, which is your team, will not continue to do a few simple things if they lack clarity and focus because you're teaching and training them too much information. So what I want you to realize is this: this is your responsibility as a leader to put in place what I like to call the positive boundaries. And when I say positive boundaries, here's what I mean. it's as important for you to tell your team what they shouldn't be doing as it is for them to tell them what they should be doing. Now, at the end of the day, they're all adults. They're independent business owners. They'll decide for themselves what they're going to do and what they're going to focus on. But if you're not giving them that direction, that's a major reason why people fail. So here's what I want you to do coming off this video today. I want you to be honest with yourself, and I want you to give yourself an assessment of how you're training your team. Look, with your five percenters, pour into them all you want. Give them the advanced training. Teach them everything you know, because they're like sponges and they're ready for that and they're hungry for that. But the 95 percenters, you can't do that. Identify the basic principles and the basic training that somebody needs for success and repeat that over and over. Keep it simple, get them focused, give them the clarity and the confidence to take action. And what will happen is some of those people will move into the 5% and you'll be able to pour into them once that happens. So that's my message for you today. Are you overtraining and teaching your team? If so, let's not have you make that mistake moving forward. And hey, listen, if you're new to my channel and you know you need to be better when it comes to being a leader in your network marketing business, I want you to click the video you see right above. I'm going to share with you in another video I did the number one thing that you need to do to be a better leader in your business. It will produce results instantly. So make sure you click that and check it out. But thanks for being here. If you got some value, make sure you subscribe, like the video. I would really appreciate it. Take care.